I think I need to watch something.
I think you need to watch it too.
Right after this, we'll put it on as I'm breaking down.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, it's hilarious. Oh.
Yes, you guys should watch BBC Animal Crackers because
Alan.
Steve.
What?
Yes. Okay.
Oh, I know what you're talking about.
You've probably seen parts of it.
Like the bird.
Yeah, there's a few variations, but there's one that's definitely better than the others.
Is it like actually on the BBC or is it just some dude who like put the
I think
YouTube?
It's actually by BBC.
No.
BBC's pretty badass.
Yes.
Badass broadcasting company. That's what they should call it. Hi. You're watching Beer Fork. My name is Melanie. This is Mariah. And we have another beer for you today, and it is by Thirsty Dog Brewing Company. We've had, I think, one other beer by them. I can't remember. Because I know we had Barktoberfest in our refrigerator at one point. I don't know if it made it on the show or not. Anyhow, we have another beer by them, and it is called the 12 Dogs of Christmas Ale. So they're sticking with their dog theme. Very cute. And it is an ale brewed with honey and spices. And it says, this beer's name sums up the idea of bringing the best together to celebrate. It is filled with seasonal flavors from generous amounts of toasted and caramel malts, mixed with equally generous amounts of honey, cinnamon, ginger, and nutmeg. We feel it is the perfect libation filled with flavors of the season. And it is right at 8.3% ABV. And this one does tell us the temperature. It says best served at 43 to 49 degrees. So a little bit on the cooler side from some of the other darker beers that we've had. Darn, I was going to say something and I cannot remember what it was. Oh well, carry on.
I like that they called it a libation.
Yeah.
And that there's ginger in it.
Yeah, this one sounded like there's a lot of flavors going on.
I'm really hoping for more ginger this time.
I think we had one recently that was pretty spot on. It was very much gingerbready, not like ginger.
Okay.
I'll have to go back and figure out which one that was. All right, so looking good. So a little bit ahead there. Nice, clear, light amber color.
Very clear, pretty see-through.
You know what? There's not much in the way of bubbles on this one.
No.
Not very effervescent. That was interesting. I was smelling something before I even got into the beer and it smelled kind of like soap. And I think it is the beer.
Are you sure it's not the glass?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I didn't. Yeah.
I'm always afraid.
When I get closer into it, I think it is the beer. Like, at a distance, it smells like soap. Not bad soap, but good soap. But then when I get in, it smells good. I think you're gonna like it.
Okay.
What do
Sometimes
you get?
I'm afraid that I've washed my dishes badly or something, and then the soap is what I'm smelling.
Yeah. I mean, we're pretty good about just like, just straight up rinsing it after it's come out of the dishwasher.
Which
and
is good.
Yeah, no hand washing. Yeah.
Smells fresh.
I like the way it smells. I definitely get the nutmeg. I get ginger. I get honey.
Sorry, I'm gonna grab this. I feel like I need to double check what the spices were that they listed.
Yeah, they had a whole bunch of flavors going on that they were like pointing out and I'm getting them.
I smell the soapy now. Right? It's almost... They don't list cardamom on there?
No.
Like, maybe soapy, like floral is kind of what I'm smelling.
Yeah. I think it's really the honey. And the way that it's pairing up with the spices.
Okay.
I like the way it smells. I think it smells really good. Like, this has been one of the better smelling beers that we've had recently.
Just by smell, I don't think I'm gonna like it, but I am excited to taste it.
All right.
I'm sure that my nose is wrong.
Well, let's have that.
It tastes clean.
I like it. It does taste clean.
It's the soap flavor.
I totally ruined this by saying soap. But it is kind of got this interesting soap-ish thing happening to it.
It's not a bad thing, we promise.
Yeah. Actual drinking of it.
I like it.
I like it. I feel like the spices are not so much in the actual flavors that you get until you've swallowed, and the aftertaste is actually where I'm picking up way more of the spices. Like, it leaves a really, really nice aftertaste. Kind of the aftertaste of having eaten a gingerbread cookie.
Yeah.
Yeah. I like this one.
Again, totally gonna sound weird. It's got an almost vegetable-y aftertaste, not in a bad way.
Yeah, because it's not sweet.
It's just that fresh that's coming through, and I don't know what to pin it on. I'm
trying to think if I can find what you're talking about so I can help you out. Like, I think I know where you're going with it. Like, it's got sort of a root vegetable thing. But I don't know where that would be coming from.
I mean, there could be more spices than are on the label. I do like this one. This is quite tasty.
Even though you think it tastes like soap and vegetables.
Soap, vegetables, spices. Yeah.
I think it tastes mostly just like a good ale with a nice gingerbread finish. It's not sweet. It's not over the top. It's just good.
I like it. So... we've said soap, we've said vegetables. I think it tastes fresh. I think it does have a nice, not overly bold.
And we are back. We apologize. We had a little malfunction there, but we were just discussing
this not disgusting beer.
Yeah, we were trying to clarify a little bit of like the vegetable, and I was describing it as like, I don't know if you guys have ever had like rutabaga, parsnips, or jicama. It's got this sort of earthy, like dirt earthy thing to it. And I think, because this has happened with another beer, like with the spices, there's something about, I think, the association of the spices that like literally gives you that feel in your mouth, and I wonder if that's where you were going with it.
Maybe, yeah.
Okay.
I don't know anymore.
It doesn't taste like celery.
It doesn't taste bad. It's really good, I promise. And I'm saying it tastes like vegetables as somebody who really likes vegetables.
It doesn't taste like spinach. I gotta pick on you just a little bit.
I think it tastes like spinach and lettuce in a really good way.
Yeah, I'm telling you, it's like that little nice bit of earthiness, but I associate that earthiness with a good gingerbread cookie, too.
This beer's awesome.
Yeah. Of all the beers that we've had, pick this one up. This one is definitely worth it. It's very enjoyable, very easy to drink, not over the top sweet. I would really like to actually have this one with some food, you know?
I would too. I was just like taking a peek at the label. This one's 8.3% ABV. So you could quickly drink it down and not realize just how much you're drinking.
Yeah. So eat some cookies with it.
Eat some gingerbread with it, or some spinach, or whatever.
Or turkey. I want turkey. Ham.
Eat anything with it.
Yeah, this would actually, I think, pair well with just about anything. I could eat this with some oranges.
I don't like oranges, but okay. I know, I'm weird.
Okay, thank you guys for watching again. I'm Melanie, this is Mariah. You're watching Beer Fork. Thanks for watching. It is the most wonderful time for a beer. If you've got something to say, give us a like or send us a comment. If you want to see more, we would love for you to subscribe. You can also check us out on Untappd, Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook. And to see more videos, check them out over here.